Hello, welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. This is another session of trigonometry, application of trigonometry. So we are going to discuss some few more questions which will be applicable in height and distance. And let me write some questions. Question is here. The angle of elevation. The angle of elevation. Write down. Of the top and bottom, or write first simple question, top of a tower is 30 degree, after walking 20 meter towards the tower, the angle of elevation would be angle of elevation of tower is 45 degree. Find the height of tower. This is a question, right? So how to deal with such question? The angle of elevation of a tower is 30 degree from any point on the ground, right? After walking 20 meter towards the tower, the angle of elevation of tower is 45 degree. What is the height of the tower? So, solution. It is, this is a tower, you know, and this is the point of observation where the angle is 30 degree. This angle is 30 degree. But when moving towards the tower with the some distance, the angle of elevation is 45 degree and this distance is 20 meter. So first observation point is here. This is point B. AB is a tower and C is another point. So at D point, the observer observes that angle of elevation of tower is 30 degree. But when he walks 20 meter towards the tower like this side, the angle of elevation become 45 degree. We have to find height of tower. So net height of tower is h, and this distance is x. I can assume. Let AB is a tower. Is a tower of height h. Height h, and BC is equal to x meter. Now, I can check out in triangle ABC. So in triangle ABC, in this triangle, one edge that has to be find out is h, and another thing that is unknown is x. In these two, what will be the relation? Tan, because side opposite to acute angle is a opposite side, that is called perpendicular, and side the another side. Apart from hypotenuse is called adjacent. So perpendicular and adjacent, that is base, has relation tan. So tan 45 degree is equal to h upon x, but tan 45 is nothing else, 1 h is equal to x, and therefore h is equal to x. We can write equation 1. Now again, in triangle ABD, tan 30 degree is equal to, what will happen? H divided by perpendicular divided by base, and this base is nothing else but x plus 20. Now I can write 1 by root 3 is equal to h upon x is also equal to h, and we have to find h. So x can be eliminated, h plus 20. Now h plus 20 is equal to root 3h. This implies h plus 20 is equal to root 3h. And therefore, if h will come this side, it will be root 3 minus 1 into h is equal to 20. And now, if you multiply this, h is equal to what come? 20 upon root 3 minus 1. Now, we can rationalize it, root 3 plus 1 and root 3 plus 1. What will happen? 20 into root 3 plus 1. And in denominator, a minus b, a plus b. A square minus b square, root 3 square is 3, 3 minus 1 is 2, so 20 upon 2 into root 3 plus 1, 2 can cancel 10 times, so 10 into root 3 plus 1 meter, that will be the height of the tower. And therefore, don't forget to write like this, height of the tower is 10 into root 3 plus 1 meter, that will be the answer. No need to put the value of root 3 as 1.732, because that will give the approximate value and that can be written as accurate value. So you may write like this only, right? So this is the question, what is that? This is the different that the question what we had discussed in the last class, because in last class we have only one angle of elevation. Now we introduced today in which there are two angle of elevations and there are two correlated factors, two related relations are given. We have to assume two unknown variables are there. We have to eliminate one of them. So try to understand once again this question. And the angle of elevation of top of a tower is 30 degree. After walking 20 meter towards the tower, the angle of elevation of tower become 45 degree. Find the height of the tower that you have to calculate. So this is the first point of observation. From here the angle of elevation is 30 degree, but after walking nearer towards the tower, the angle of elevation become 45 degree. You have to calculate the height of the tower. So this question, now write one more question of the similar category so that it will be consolidated. Question is, the angle of elevation of the top of a tree from the ground is 45 degree after moving, or 60 degree you can write, 60 degree after moving 50 meter away from the tree, the angle of elevation becomes 45 degree. Find the height of tree. Similar question, bit different, and that is why I can write like this. Here again, if you are looking for the question, how to deal with such question, the angle of elevation of top of a tower, not but here top of a tree, is something given, and tree, height of tree we have to calculate. Here instead of moving towards the tower or towards the tree, here he is moving away from the tree. So this is a tree, you know, and that tree is there, and this is a tree, you know, and the angle of elevation at the tree is at from certain position is 60 degree, and after moving 50 meter away from this point, that angle of elevation is goes to how much? 45 degree. So we need to calculate the height of the tree. Let me draw some realistic figure, and what is that? And this is this is 60 degree, you know, the angle of elevation from this top point is 60 degree. So that was 60 degree, and after moving away from this point, the angle of elevation is, sorry, let me write some straight line. Okay, so that will be probably 45 degree. So this is 45 degree that we have to calculate, and this distance is 50 meter away from the tree. So we have to calculate the same thing here also, but this is 60 degree and this is 45 degree. Let height of the tree is, let height of the tree, is h meter. So this height is considered to be h meter, right? And now in triangle, this is say AB is a tree, C and D are point of observation. Let AB is a tree, AB is a tree, and C and D are point of observation. So now in triangle ABC, if I say BC is equal to X, then what will happen? This is X, and tan 60 is equal to what? H by X. That is root 3 is equal to H by X, and therefore H is equal to under root 3X. This is equation 1. Now in triangle ABD, tan 45 degree is equal to what will happen? That is H for this triangle 45 degree, this is perpendicular and this complete one is base. So H upon X plus 50, so tan 45 is nothing else but 1 is equal to H plus H divided by X plus 50. This employee H is equal to X plus 50. This is equation 2. Now we have to find H, so we can substitute X, and X is nothing else but H by root 3. From this equation, X is equal to H by root 3, so put in second. So from first, we can write H is equal to H by root 3 plus 50, and this employee H minus H by root 3 is equal to 50. That is root 3H, this will be minus H upon root 3 is equal to 50. Now we can write root 3 minus 1 into H is equal to 50 root 3. If you multiply by root 3 plus 1 both the sides, you will get it 2H is equal to 50 root 3 into root 3 plus 1, right now? 50 root 3 into root 3 plus 1, if I would multiply both the sides by root 3 plus 1, H. If you are not able to understand it, let me write here freely, that will be possible. So, here I can write it, H is equal to 50 root 3 divided by root 3 minus 1, so multiply by root 3 plus 1, numerator and denominator, just to rationalize it, it will come 50 root 3 into root 3 plus 1 divided by a minus b, a plus b, a square, that is 3, minus b square, that is 2. So this can cancel by 25 times. So it will be 25, and root 3 multiplied by root 3 is 3 plus root 3 meter. And that will be answer of this question. So height of the tree is 25 into 3 plus root 3 meter. I hope you got it. First of all, you have to find the relation out of the one small triangle, and that relation can be used in bigger right angle triangle, and on the basis of that you will be able to answer those questions. Got it? I hope you got it. So let me discuss some other questions where more than two figures are there. Now what I wanted to write in the beginning of the question, that I am writing here, right, question is, the angle of elevation, the angle of depression from a top of a tower to the top and bottom of 10 meter high building are 45 degree and 60 degree respectively. find the height of the tower. Height of the tower. Right. This is question. To solve this question, what to do? Here, this is a tower and 10 meter high building. This is a building. AB is a tower and CD is a building. And height of building is 10 meter only. That is given. It is given that the angle of depression from top of a tower, means observer is sitting here and he can observe well that the angle of the line of sight is like this. His line of sight is this. And when he dropped, want to see the top of building, he has to turn down, and therefore the angle of elevation, depression, angle of depression will be 45 degree. Top is 45 degree, and when he want to see bottom of the building, he has to turn down something more, and in that case the angle will be 60 degree. So we have to find the height of the tower. That we have to calculate. So here, let h be the height of the tower, and that can be calculated. Now the building is 10 meter. So if I write here, that will be also 10 meter, right now? Say this is x, the distance between building and this is x. Now this would be h minus 10. So in this one, this will be h minus 10. Now I can calculate this using this fact. That this is 45 degree, that will be also 45 degree, and this is 60 degree, so this will be also 60 degree, as we had discussed in the previous question, that these are alternate angles, and that is why they will be equal. Got the point? I hope so. Yes, you are getting this point. This is the 60 degree, that angle is 60 degree, so alternate angle of this is 60 degree, this is 45 degree. So we can go with the smaller triangle first. In triangle A, let the name is given, AB and CD are building, this is point E. We can write for the reference, let solution is this. Let AB is a tower and CD is a building. Right now, AB is a tower and CD is a building. So in triangle AEC, tan 45 degree is equal to, if this one is x, that will be also x. Tan 45 degree is equal to, what is that? H minus 10 divided by x. Tan 45 is 1. So h minus 10 is equal to x, and therefore x is equal to h minus 10, that is equation first. Now in triangle ABD, bigger triangle ABD, try to understand, this is a bigger triangle ABD, this is angle is 60 degree, so we can write tan 60 degree is equal to, what is that? Complete height is h and this is x, so h by x, and therefore tan 60 is root 3. You remember now? Tan 60 is root 3. Root 3 is equal to h by x, and therefore h is equal to x is equal to what? H by root 3. This is equation second. Now we have to find the value of h, so we can replace x. X can be compared, so from first we can write h minus 10 is equal to h by root 3, that means h minus h by root 3, this will come this side negative, it will be 10. Further, I can write root 3h minus h upon root 3 is equal to 10, and therefore now we can write root 3 minus 1 into h is equal to 10 root 3, and therefore h is equal to 10 root 3 upon root 3 minus 1. Again you can slide it, what we did in the previous question, and you will be able to find it, that it will be 10 into 3 plus root 3, divided by 2, 2 cancel this 5 times, so 5 into 3 plus root 3 meter, that will be answer. That is, answer is nothing else. What, let me write here, answer is, last step was 5 into 3 plus root 3 meter, and that was the answer of this question. So in the similar way, we can deal such situations where more than one variables are there, you will be able to solve the questions in this way. I hope you got it, and you are able to solve now such equations where two angles are given and two variables may be given. You have to calculate the value of one of them, right? Okay, let me write one more question. Question 5. The angle of elevation of the top of the vertex of a tree on the other bank of the river is 30 degree, 45 degree. After moving from the bank, the angle of elevation becomes 30 degree. Find the width of the river. So this question is a bit different than the previous one. How to deal with this? This is a river. You see, this is a river. Here is one sided tree is there, and water is flowing through this river. Say, this is a river, water is flowing through this, and on one side there is a tree. Tree is here on one bank, and on other bank, here the person is going to observe this. So this is a one side, here the person is observing this, and the angle of elevation is this. Now after moving some meter, what meter? 40 meter away from this bank, 40 meter away from this bank, what is find? The angle of observation is this 30 degree. That is 30 degree. And here it was 45 degree. This is a tree, you know, and this is a river. So we have to find width of the river. So just try to understand. This is A, this is B, this is the height of the tree. C is one point of observation and D is other point of observation. So let AB is a tree, we can write in solution. Let AB is a tree, AB is a tree, and C is the point of observation on other side of bank, right? Now CD is equal to 40 meter. This is another point of observation, and we have to find BC. BC is equal to XA, Manlia, and AB is equal to H, height of tree is H, I can say. Now we have to calculate BC. So in a small triangle, first of all we will go for a small triangle, and this is X, you know, x. So in a small triangle we can calculate this height of tree is h. So tan 45 in triangle ABC, tan 45 degree is equal to h by x. This means tan 45. What is the value of tan 45? Do you know that? Remember that? What is that? 1. 1 is equal to h by x, and this employee h is equal to x, and that will be the equation 1. Now again, in triangle ABD, what will happen? Tan 30 degree is equal to h upon x plus 40, and in that case what will happen, that tan 40 30 is 1 by root 3, h upon x plus 40, that is x plus 40 is equal to root 3 h. Now x is equal to h, so we can replace h by x because we have to calculate x. So what will happen in that case, that will be, again I can write here, x we have to calculate, so x plus 40 is equal to root 3 x because h and x are equal. So we can write here, that is root 3 x minus x is equal to 40, and this employee x is equal to 40 upon root 3 minus 1, and similar way if you rationalize this will come 20 into root 3 plus 1 meter. This is the width of river, and that will be answer of this question. So I hope you are getting all this, how to deal with this question. This is the river, and on river other side a tree is standing like this, and this is the point of observation. So in this way one person can see this. Now this is the width of the river, it seems like that, not diagonally, it is vertically measured, you know. If I draw this like this will be the figure, but it looks awkward, so that is why I have drawn like this. But don't think that this is a horizontal measured like along the width of this. This is directly across the river. So one of them, if I draw the same thing, like this is the diagram, and this is a river, and this is a point here is the, this is the directly opposite to that, and the point is 20 meter away like this, then this figure will look upwards, and you will be not able to analyze that whether this is right angle triangle or not. So that is why I have drawn like this. But the summary is, you can solve the questions by taking into consideration that this is a river, one bank is this point, another bank is this point, here angle of elevation is like this, directly opposite to the opposite to the point C, the point B is situated, and here you can calculate like this. The theoretical value is the same, and the diagram can be represented like this. There is no problem, and you think that if this is a diagonally measured, that is not possible. Here this is a straightforward, just opposite to the bank is measured, and in calculation there will be no difference whatever the situation of figure may be. So such questions where more than one angles are given, and you have to calculate that one of the lesson. In this question even, some people may ask, what is the height of the tree? So height of the tree, h and x are same, so even height of tree can be calculated also as 20 into root 3 plus 1 meter, right now? So if you practice all these questions of this category where more than two variables are given, more than two variables are required, and two angle of elevation or two angle of depressions are given, you will be able to solve the questions quickly. And in next class, we will discuss some more questions about the height and distance. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you very much for watching the video, and keep in touch. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. All the best.